Hello students, now in this class we are going to see very important topics in this lesson, current electricity. Today we are going to see the session number 4 and very important rules which are formulated by Kirchhoff's, the voltage and current rule. We are going to see the Wheatstone bridge, one of the important questions in our plus 2 physics. First of all, let me start with the Kirchhoff rule, and this is the important rule which is used in most of the electronic systems. Actually, Ohm's law is useful for simple circuits. For more complex circuits, Kirchhoff's rules can be used to find current and voltage. There are two generalized rules. One is Kirchhoff's current rule, which is called as first rule, and Kirchhoff's voltage rule, and it is mentioned as Kirchhoff's second rule. First of all, let's start with Kirchhoff's first rule, which is current rule or junction rule. Actually, this rule states that an algebraic sum of the currents at any junction of a circuit is zero. Let me give one example for you. If you see a electric post in our street, you can see lot of connections are there like this. Is it so? Yeah, this is the post. Okay, this is your house connection and next house connection and some other house connection. There are several connections are in one light post. Okay, just imagine if all the houses are taken to phase current, then each and every houses are allowed to current mostly of 230 volt, but we cannot use the full 230 volt at a time in our house. So we have to return the current. That means the government or the EB board allowed for 230 volt for us to occur on that particular time, but we are not ready to occur that 230 volt at that particular time. So we take only 60, 70 or 100 volt and we left the current in that same line. Remember, if you do that again and again, what will happen? The reverse current in that area and the reverse current which is in that post will make a big damage. Okay, but that's not happening here. All the houses which are nearby you will reverse the current which they are not used, but there is no problem in the circuit of the post, electric post. See why it has to be happen but it's not happening in the post. Why? It's all because of this rule, Kirchhoff's rule. That is the algebraic sum all together, the full 5 or 6 connections are totaling and they are called as algebraic sum of the currents at any junction. This junction of a circuit is zero. It equals all the other currents. Let me give some examples for this. All charges that enter of a given junction in a circuit must leave that junction, since charge cannot build or disappear at a junction. Okay, so current entering the junction is taken as positive and current leaving the junction is taken as negative. So after the usage, we left the current to the same electrical post as negative. Negative will not make any impact in the circuit. So applying this law to the junction A, we get See, this is I1, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5. And imagine this is your house and your neighbor's house. Okay, you are sending the current return. And in that, according to Kirchhoff rule, it is taken as I1 plus I2 minus I3 minus I4 minus I5 is equal to 0. So, this I1 and I2 will equals the I3, I4 and I5. Okay, like this, the current in each and every house's circuits are equaled with other circuits. So, the currents at any junction is at 0. Now, let's see the Kirchhoff's second rule. And it is called as voltage rule or loop rule. It says that in a closed circuit, the algebraic sum of the products of the current and resistance of each part of the circuit is equal to the total EMF included in the circuit. Let me show one. Which is going A to B. Okay. This is going A to B. And this is going B to A. Here the voltage is equal to plus IR. And here voltage is equal to minus IR. And here the going to A to B. Voltage is equal to minus plus pi psi. And this is voltage equal to minus sine. Suppose if the direction of current is opposite to the direction of the loop, then the product of current and voltage across the resistor is negative. The EMF is considered positive when proceeding for the negative to the positive terminal. Let me give one other example for you. See, in every houses, as I mentioned earlier, in the parallel circuit of parallel resistors or parallel conductors, every house has to develop a different current circuits in their electrical panel, because each and every rooms require a different electrical appliances. See, you cannot use your fridge or a or your washing machine or your mixie or grinder in a hall. Okay, so you have to have a separate connection for that in a separate room. That's why we use the mixie or grinder in our kitchen and the washing machine in our nearby bathrooms, and we use the TV and AC in the living rooms. So the current connection has to be separated as it is in the board. That's why the Kirchhoff's second rule states that the circuit and the closed circuit and the algebraic sum of the products of the current and the resistance of each part of the circuit, that means resistance and the conductors of the each and every rooms, is equal to the total EMF included in the circuit. They are concluded as a full circuit after the connections. But in between the rooms, the requirement and the passage of currents are different. They are not equal. Even though we have two rooms, we have to differentiate the current as it is according to the requirement of that room. So, Kirchhoff voltage rule has to be applied only when all the currents in the circuit reach a steady state condition. This is what very important in that. Now, let's see the conditions for bridge balance in Wheatstone bridge. Students, this is a very important question, and which they have to ask this very frequently in examinations. So, let's move to this. An important application of Kirchhoff's rule is the Wheatstone bridge, and it is used to compare the resistance and to determine the unknown resistance in an electrical network. Now let's have the our consists the four resistance we use here. They are P, Q, R and S, as I shown in the figure. Now a galvanometer G is connected in between the points B and D. The battery is connected between the point A and C. Let me show. This is the Wheatstone bridge connection. P, Q and R, S are some resistance. A and C are connected with the positive and negative terminals of the battery, and which have a EMF of psi, and current I1 to P and I2 to R, I3 to Q and I4 to S. Now let's see what's the current movement. Let I1, I2, I3 and I4 be the currents through various branches, and the current through the galvanometer IG and its resistance is G. Okay, capital G. First one, let us apply the Kirchhoff first rule to the junction B. We are going to apply the Kirchhoff first rule to the junction B. See, we are giving a current I1 which is plus, but here in this terminal it has been divided into two segments. One is IG and another one is I3. Okay, while having a positive current here, it loses its positive and it gives to I3 and IG. So I1 minus IG minus I3 is equal to 0. Second, applying the Kirchhoff first rule to the junction D. Here we receive current, positive current from I2, and at this terminal we receive the positive current from G because it already received the positive current from IG, I1, and so IG have a positive current, so we add I2 plus IG and it gives current to I4, this circuit. Okay, so we put minus here. If you have any doubt in this terminals, kindly check with me, because it's very easy question, but you have to understand properly. Now applying Kirchhoff's second rule to the loop ABDA. What is the loop here? A, B, D and again A. A first half cycle of this Wheatstone bridge. A, B, D and again A. So what are the currents here? One, first one is I1P and the second one is IG into capital G and I2 into R. Here this I1P and IGG are positive, but we lose current at I2, so it is minus. I1P plus IGG minus I2R is equal to 0. This is equation number 3. And the fourth one, applying Kirchhoff's second rule to loop A, B, C, D, A. So A, B, C, D, A, full terminal and all the four diodes we use here. So I1P and I3G, we give I1 current and it also get from I3. So I1P plus I3Q minus I24, here we lose current and again we lose current here at I2R. Okay. When the points B and D are at same potential, then there is no potential difference between B and D. So no current flows through the galvanometer IG. So the IG is equal to 0. If you substitute the value of IG equal to 0 in equation number 1, 2 and 3, we get I1 is equal to I3 equation number 5, I2 is equal to I4, equation number 6, I1P is equal to I2R, which is termed as equation number 7. Now substituting the equation 5 and 6 and in equation number 4, we get, if you substitute the values of I1 and I2 in equation number 4, we get I1P plus I1Q minus I2S minus I2R, which is equal to 0. So I1P plus Q and I2R plus S, which we take I1 as common here and I2 as common here, and equate this equation left and right. Now dividing equation 8 by equation 7, we get P plus Q by P, which is equal to R plus S by R. That is, dividing this one I1 and this I1, so we get P plus Q by R P, and dividing I2 here and I2 here, so R plus S by R. Taking P as common, so 1 plus Q by P or 1 plus S by R, then we can neglect both I1 and 1 here. So Q by P is equal to S by R, or P by Q is equal to R by S. This is the bridge balance condition. Under this condition, galvanometer shows null deflection. Thank you, students. See you in the next class.